Here's my LS3 engine crate. This one's got the cross braces on it. There's also another version that's got just regular panels. Comes apart into three pieces. You take the top off, and you can take the sides off. And the engine sits on the base. You can then plug it in and turn it on. You can also take it apart. All the parts are designed to fit on a smaller 220mm by 220mm printer bed. You can actually print them, most of them diagonally. I would recommend printing them all on an edge. That way you don't have to have a shiny side that you have to sand later. You can actually print two of them at a time in some cases, like this. The corner piece, you will have to put one of the sides down on that one. You can only print one at a time. And for these, to get rid of the shiny part, I just sanded them down. And it looks a lot better. Got all my printed parts laid out here for the engine crate. I printed them out in a wood-colored PLA, most of the parts in the brown. I printed out the sides and the side brackets in a light-colored wood PLA. You can also, I also have examples of the sides with the braces on them. I printed out the same color. You see those in my pictures. We've got five of the middle base pieces, the two end pieces, the three rails where the forklift would go underneath. We got the engine cradle. These parts here are for the sides, the corner pieces, the bottom planks, top planks, and then this is for the top panel itself, the ends and the sides, and all the panels, of course. Got a new electric screwdriver I just bought yesterday. We'll see how this works. If it runs out of power, go back to the trusty Allen screw or Allen wrench. And I've got a clamp to help out putting these together. We've got a bunch of the 3mm by 10mm socket head screws for most of the sides and the top. Got a few 12mm ones for that are a little bit longer to hold the side brackets. And a whole bunch of 16mm ones for the base. So let's start putting it together.